Hey, what is up guys? Klassen here, and today I'm going to talk about why this sign is garbage. So obviously I don't mean any disrespect to this or any other gym owner. If I was a gym owner, I might have something similar to this up on my walls. But the do not drop your weight sign, I think is just straight up dangerous. And I think one of the only reasons that gym owners don't want you to drop their weights is because you can break the dumbbells, you can break mirrors, you can break whatever. It's a danger to profits, it's a danger to finances. So obviously there's the safety risk that comes with dropping your dumbbells, right? If you're not paying attention, you could drop a dumbbell in your or someone else's foot, and that wouldn't be good for anybody, right? If you're careless and you drop your weights, then sure, a sign like this has merit. But I think that in most cases, not dropping your weights can put you at even more of a risk for hurting yourself or others. So this sign here says that if you have to drop your weights, you're lifting weights that are too heavy for you. That's half true. If you're holding a weight that's too heavy for you and you need to drop it, your body's saying, let go, I can't handle this, I can't do it anymore. And then it says, let go, and then you let go of the weights. So that's your body's own self-protection kicking in, right? Drop it, I can't do this anymore. And then you let it go, right? Which is not a good thing. If you're bench pressing, then you'll just crush yourself in the chest, right? But no one is ever concerned about dropping your barbell while you're bench pressing. It's more people who do dumbbell chest presses or overhead presses, stuff like that, right? But this is the thing here. If I'm gonna do a dumbbell bench press, for example, a lot of times when people get tired of their dumbbell bench press, they come down and let their weights go like that, right? The worst thing about it is that it's loud and it startles people. Now obviously if there's somebody right next to you, you don't wanna be a jerk, okay? You wanna be self-aware of the fact that if you're gonna be dropping your weights, make sure there's no one beside you, make sure that there's no risk of you crushing anything, like a shaker cup. I've done that before. I've come down with my dumbbells and destroyed my shaker cup, which sucks, but it's better than someone else's foot. But if I'm working with a dumbbell and I get to this point and I think, oh, I better drop this. This isn't good. I can't push this anymore. But then I think, oh yeah, I'm not allowed to drop my dumbbells. Then what happens is you become at risk for a muscle tear, right? You're trying to hold weight your body can't hold anymore. And then the dumbbell gets to this point right here, then your chest would stretch beyond what it can handle, and then boom, you got a tear. So that's something that we want to avoid, right? So in most instances, if your body's telling you to drop the weight, then I think that you should, as long as you're not hurting somebody else, right? Like, your body is more important than gym equipment. That being said, you do want to train respectfully, right? Especially if it's not your own equipment. Point number two. If you're someone who enjoys strength training, like myself, you're working with weights that are very heavy. So something like a dumbbell chest press, for example, it's just not even realistic for you to have the dumbbells in this position and to safely, you know, bring them in and then crunch all that weight up with your abs, especially if you're doing like a heavy dumbbell lift. It's just not realistic. It's more dangerous for you to attempt to bring these dumbbells up onto your lap and rest them down than it would be just to drop the weights. So if a sign says if you're lifting weights that you have to drop, you're not strong enough to be lifting those weights, yeah, that's the point. That's why I'm lifting those weights, because I want to get strong enough so that I get comfortable with them, and then I'm gonna move up. I think just exercising with weights in general, resistance training with weight, always comes with that risk. No matter what weight you're using, there's always the risk that you could drop, that you could get hurt, whatever. So if someone is dropping their weights, I'm more so just happy that they didn't get hurt themselves. My next example is probably the exercise that gets the worst rep for being loud and obnoxious and people dropping their weights, and that's the deadlift. The thing about the deadlift is that you can move a lot of weight with it. That's why it's such an excellent strength builder. But the problem is that this downward motion can be very hard on your lower back and your hips. And if you're moving weight that's very heavy, it's safer for you to just drop the barbell and let it hit the ground than it is for you to slowly try and move this heavy amount of weight down on your back that's already caving, which is why your body's telling you, hey, let this weight go, I can't handle it anymore. All of that weight that you're slowly trying to drop so that you don't scare anybody and that you don't piss the gym owner off, all of that weight is sitting right on your lower back, and then boom, you have a lower back injury. And then deadlifts has this rep of being such a dangerous exercise. I don't do deadlifts. I don't want to wreck my lower back. Oh, I have low back pain. Well, yeah, if people stop freaking out every time someone drops a barbell, maybe people would be hurting their backs less doing deadlifts. And I've come across this a lot, and I've worked at gyms, and it's been part of my job to yell at people who drop their weight. So what's the takeaway from this? Is it to rise against the system and stick it to the man and stick it to your gym owners and say, screw you and screw your signs, I'm gonna do what I want? No. And I have the most respect for gym owners who have signs up against dropping weights. Like, get where they're coming from. They don't wanna break their equipment. They don't want other people to get hurt. They wanna create a respectful gym environment, right? Besides, they own the gym, their rules. They don't want you to drop the weights. You can't drop your weights. It doesn't really matter what I think or what you think, or what anybody else thinks. You gotta follow the rules of the gym you're in. That being said, this is your solution, okay? You're gonna find a gym that tolerates dropping weights. It's as simple as that. You gotta find the workout environment that's gonna tolerate you and your goals. So don't go to some family-friendly cardio bunny gym. If you wanna get really strong at doing deadlifts, go to a powerlifting gym or a strongman gym or a gym that just tolerates dropping weights or people who are strength training. Yeah, those gyms are a little bit more intimidating, but no one looks at you in disgust every time you drop a barbell, because these people know you're working with heavier weights. And sometimes it's safer to just drop the weight than it is to put your body at risk and tear muscles that'll affect you for the rest of your life. Okay, Zach, I don't have any gyms in my area like this. I can't find anything like this. I'm stuck in the gym I'm at. What do I do? I was strength training at a gym. I didn't really tolerate people who did powerlifting or any kind of heavy lifting. And every time you dropped the dumbbells, everyone looked at you and they were pissed. You could see it in their eyes. So what I did is that if I was gonna do something, I knew I was gonna make a lot of noise, and I knew that I was going to, you know, potentially risk dropping the weights. Get some of these exercise mats. Every gym's got them. Put them down on the floor, then if you're gonna drop your weights, drop it on the mat. Put two mats down, right? That muffles the sound, and if you ever have to drop your weights, at least people can see you're trying, right? You're making an effort. It's visually there. So in conclusion, yes, sometimes it's dangerous to drop your weights because you could hurt the people around you or break your equipment. But the main takeaway of this video is that, yes, but sometimes it's more dangerous for you not to drop your weights, right? If there are situations where it's safer for you to not drop your weights, you have to understand that there are also going to be situations where it is safer for you to drop the weight, right? Don't blow out your shoulder. Don't blow out your lower back. Play it safe. Drop your weights. Klassen out.